Republican senator from key swing state getting laughs, not in a good way. Unclear exactly who, you know, what the makeup of the audience is in terms of their politics. But when she's getting laughs when she attempts to defend the president, do you see his words or deeds as a problem for the GOP? Or do you think this is something that is just, you know, this news cycle?
Listen, I don't think that anybody should go out and try to defend every word that the president of the United States says or every tweet that the president tweets about. If Senator Ernst needs to go out and defend her record, she needs to defend what she's trying to do for her constituents in the state of Iowa and focus on that. And that also includes not having this government shut down. And so when you look at 2018, you looking forward to how that's going to impact the GOP. I think this White House has to stay on message. This White House has to stay focused on the things that they are doing right, the things that this president is leading on when it comes to this economy and the tax cuts that are going to take place. And you'll start to feel them in your pocketbooks next month, and leading to infrastructure and all the other positive things that this administration is actually doing and should get credit for. Those are winning messages. And I think that's what they should focus on. And I think this too shall pass. Just stay focused.
Bakari, will this pass?
I'm hesitant to say that it won't. It won't just be a phase, because everything we've seen in Donald Trump's trajectory since he came down the steps and called Mexicans rapist has been, you know, momentary, has been this day, then the next day, then there's another news cycle and another news cycle, and people are just getting exhausted. It's the equivalent to, you know, drinking out of a fire hose. It's just very, very difficult. But I don't think that everybody just has to be a coward. I mean, I think that you can have more people like, for example, Governor Charlie Baker, who I was a part of a Martin Luther King Day program with him this morning in Boston, who spoke about the fact that his mother had Alzheimer's and he had a Haitian immigrant and an Ethiopian immigrant that cared for her, understanding the value that they bring to the United States of America, talking about the value of diversity. Now, we may disagree on tax policy, but we understand what it means to be American. And, you know, the irony in this is that Rich was talking about a merit-based system and making $100,000 and this and that. And then I'm pretty sure that you go out and you quote Dr. Martin Luther King Jr., which is the antithesis thereof. And so when people actually don't understand the essence of the day, when they don't understand the value of the moment that we're in, and I'm not worried about the words of our enemies, to quote Dr. King, I'm worried about the silence of our friends. And if Joni wants to be an upright American, if she wants to stand for all the virtues, if Rich wants to stand for all the virtues of being American, then now is not the time to be a coward. Now is the time to stand up for something.
I don't understand what's un-American about celebrating Indian immigrants who come here and right. succeed. What's wrong with that? Why are you laughing? That's a bad thing.
Well, actually, what I was pointing to is the fact that we have vast income inequality in this country, and that you don't have to simply make $100,000 to be welcomed in the United States. In fact, if you work with your hands, you're welcomed in the United States.
Right.
Well, if you're a nursing assistant, you're welcome in the United States. If you're a teacher and you're making $30,000, you're welcome in the United States.
This is part of the point.
And so, you don't have to have some merit that's tied to some materialism.
Yeah, we have a problem with, we've seen it, you know, for 10 years, more maybe going back 30 years, whereas people lower people lower down the income scale, both natives and legal immigrants, who have had a real problem with wage stagnation. And it's just a basic law of economics, supply and demand. If you flood lower down in that labor market with new immigrants, you're going to, at least at the margins, depress wages. So why are we choosing to do that when we have so many people who want to come here? We can actually go with a system like Canada has. Maybe, do you think Canada is a racist country? They have a points-based, merits-based system. Australia, I guess another closed, racist society, has a point-based, merit-based system where you bring people in who can actually succeed when they first get here in a 21st century economy.
One at a time.
Anna, what's wrong with that?
Nothing's wrong with that. I mean, it's a precise. We need a modern day immigration system that addresses the needs of our modern day economy. The problem is that right now we are nowhere. Frankly, if Donald Trump wants to change the narrative that he's a racist, and you know, you ask the question, is this a phase? is this going to pass? It will pass because we have limited attention span, and also because Donald Trump is the Baskin Robbins of outrageous, offensive comments. He's got 31 flavors of outrage and offensive comments he can dole out. And so it'll be another comment in a few days, but we will remember that he said, look at my African-American over there. We will remember his statements after Charleston. We will remember the shithole statements. It will all be, it's all part of a narrative. If Donald Trump wants to change this narrative,
right,
what he should do is act on immigration. Bring in those same senators and congresspeople who were there at that meeting and tell them, let us work out a plan that can pass muster. Donald Trump needs to lead on this.
I got to end it there.